Hey, it's Calvin, and this is The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, and I'm having way too much fun in this village, guys. We're actually exactly where we were in the last episode, but like little details I didn't notice the first time. Stuff like this, look at the little colored, like, the colored rocks that make the ground, like the water look so pretty. Oh man, this is definitely my favorite village, or I guess area in the entire game so far. It was Zora's Domain, but I'm so glad that I eventually got to go here. Playing Twilight Princess and Ocarina of Time for the first time ever, actually. I took a break at, like, episode 19, but I'm so glad that after the Wind Waker, I saw the beauty in just, like, playing through a Zelda game all in, like, one go, you know? I'm so glad that I did do that, and I'm so glad that I am doing that. If I do sound weird today, I said in the last episode, but it's a little bit worse today. I had, like, a sore on my... Not a sore, I bit my the side of my cheek. It happens, guys, okay? Don't make fun of me. I bit the side of my cheek, and then today I bit my tongue. So, yeah, I'm... It's such a first world... Oh, my God, there's, like, a glass in here! Oh, my God, what the hell? Look at this context. Oh, my God, this is so cool. What are they teaching, I wonder? Look at this. It's like, That's a man. Okay, look at this. Okay, this is really cool. So the man is, like, giving love to her. And she's choking him out. Look at that. She's like, fuck off. You know what, girl? If you don't want him, I can appreciate that. That's up to you, girl. It's up to you. What's here? What's under here? Can I get under here? That is really cool context. I'm so glad sometimes I wouldn't even go into these rooms. That's so good. Yeah, so if I sound weird, I apologize. And... Oh man, we have to search this entire place. Oh god. What's really cool about these villages, and I don't know if it's going to change throughout the game. Oh my god. What? Hello? Hey, Vasak. Hey. That look. You must be the Hylian Freddy was talking about. My name is Colm. I'm Freddy's mother. We run a shop where we rent out sand seals. If you plan on crossing desert, you'll need a sand seal. What? It may seem unlikely, but we're actually a thriving business, and it's so easy for a customer to get the hang of it. All you have to do is just stand on your shield and let the... Oh my god! And of course, our sand seals have all been trained. They're much easier to handle than a sand seal you'd find in the wild. If you're in need, just let me know. Yeah, I will. Oh my god, that's so good. Oh! Oh. Was that the trailer? Was that in the trailer? Remember when you were there's a giant sandworm? Look at the context here, guys. Like, I feel like, I think for this episode we might have a discussion or a talk about context, and please, guys, get involved with it as well if you want. But context is my favorite thing in the entire world. Let's just go talk to this general right here. Hello. What are you doing in here? This is the barracks for the chief guards, not a place for tourists to gather. We're on a high alert after the recent theft. So you should clear out. What? Balara sent you? My apologies. I'm the officer in charge of the soldiers, Captain Tick. The chief's heirloom was stolen by the thieves belonging to the Yiga clan the other day, so everyone is on edge. No. We've determined that the Yiga's hideout is in Caruso Valley, but the soldiers are all exhausted, so I was just thinking about requesting some extra help. Hey everyone, listen up! The Hylian Vi has agreed to help us, so offer her any information you can. Ooh. Consider yourself a part of our unit. If you have any questions, my troops will be happy to help. Thank you very much. Okay, so wait, what? Well, we're just going? We just going. I have no problem just going. Hello, how's it going? Mm-hmm. Hey, I haven't seen Barta, but where's she gone off to? She said she was going to scout the thieves' hideout, but when she left before we could say anything. Now that I think about it, she has been gone 2 days. I wonder what happened to her. No. Are you serious? Why did you let her go by yourself? And why did you wait 2 days to report this? I apologize. She said she just wanted to check it out, and we wouldn't be careful, so I thought... I have a stroke sometimes, guys. Not really, okay. Anyone who has a family member has a stroke, I apologize for actually offending people with that. But as if we aren't busy enough searching for the chief's heirloom, now we have to find Barta too.
If the captain hears about this fiasco, she'll punish us for sure. Probably 100 laps around Gruta Desert again.
Ooh. Oh, what should we do? I'm thinking about it. I'll find Barta. Don't worry, I'll find Barta. I will find Barta. And I will bring Barta to you. Okay. Wait, okay, do you guys have any cooking places? Because I think I need to cook some food before I go anywhere near anywhere a new area, because I think that would be very dangerous to do that. I think. Any cooking places? I'm sure there has to be some cooking place here. Like, they wouldn't just have, like, an area where you couldn't cook, right? Oh, also, is there, like, a shrine around here? Because I need to pray and get an extra heart piece. I'm done with upgrading stamina, because so far my stamina has not hindered me one bit. Like, I've been having, like, not one problem with this much stamina. Like, really, not at all. Not noticeable problems. I know some people might get annoyed by the, what is it? I can smell a fire. Not smell a fire. I can hear a fire, not smell a fire. There was one back at the camp. So I guess I could travel back here really quick, because we have to travel to a shrine anyway, so, wait, here? Oh, we can't fast travel back. Oh, okay, okay. Let's see what we can do here. There must be one around here. This is a good way to just take a look around the place to see if there's anything around here. Look, we already found a sledgehammer. And what's this? A Gruta Scimitar. I don't need it. It's not even good as the rest of my weapons, so I shouldn't take it. There's still people sneaking. I love the context of this place, because it's just like a bunch of guys sneaking around the place. Let's see. There has to be some fire around here. There has to be. How do they cook things? There's a fire in like every village. There has to be a fire here. I'm just not looking in the right places. So yeah, I wanted to talk about context and how this game actually just takes it to another fucking level. I think, like, a lot of people have been telling me to play the Uncharted series. I've never played it before, and I think that might be the next thing I play on my channel after Persona 5. I do want to play another Zelda game, and I think the next blind playthrough of a Zelda game I'm going to do is going to be, I'm sorry, guys, I'm going to talk to her later. I totally will talk to her later when we come back. I'm just looking for a fire right now, and also I want to do that quest really badly as well. Is there any fire around here? I guess not. I guess not. I don't think we'll die. I mean, I don't think we'll die is like a really, really funny question. A really funny statement. I don't think we're gonna die. Okay, let's check up here really quick, because it's one other place I think we haven't looked. Yeah, Uncharted is a game that apparently is like king of context, and I have to play it eventually because context is like really important to me in video games, because I don't like, and it has to be like central to the actual game. Like, it, like, a lot of people talk about like Emperor's New Groove, and it's like how it breaks context all the time. We're just going to travel over here and go over here. It's just that simple. A lot of people talk about how it breaks context constantly, and it bothers them so much. But if you like create a world that is like, if you create a world that is prone, I guess, is that the word? Is like set up to break context and to like break the fourth wall. It's kind of like Lizzie McGuire. You ever see that? I'm using Lizzie McGuire as an example. But you ever see Lizzie McGuire the show? I don't think as many people who haven't seen Lizzie McGuire the show. It's not a bad. Let's put a marker on this just so we can walk directly in that direction. Yeah, we can walk in that direction. It's like, it's, oh my god, I couldn't pick up the other weapon because I had a fucking ladle in my hand. This direction here. So in Lizzie McGuire, they break the fourth wall a lot by having the main character. I'm not here to fight, okay? I'm not here to fight. I have just a little bit of food. I just want to cook it. But yeah, in Lizzie McGuire, they talk to the audience a lot, because it's like, they want to, like, I guess it's a running joke, but also they want to make sure the audience gets how Lizzie is feeling at that moment of time. And I don't think that it's because Hilary Duff is a bad actress, because I don't think she is a bad actress. I don't think people would say that Hilary Duff is a bad actress. She's good for what she does. Like, yeah, she wouldn't be booked in like an Oscar-winning movie, like, to the best of my knowledge anyway. I haven't watched her act before, but like, when they break the fourth wall, it's okay, because they continually do it. It's a thing that they do. It's like a running gag. They're breaking the fourth wall. It's a cartoon Lizzie McGuire breaking the fourth wall. I understand that would be worse if, like, they stopped and looked at the camera and broke the fourth wall and said, like, this is so stupid. But the thing is, another show, Malcolm in the Middle, also does that, where they, like, talk about where Malcolm will look at the camera and say, like something like, say Lois says, like, you're grounded, Malcolm. He's like, this is so stupid. He goes, says to us, this is so stupid. Reese was the guy who done it, or something like that. And you're like, you kind of understand how Malcolm's feeling a little bit better. And just like in the Emperor's New Groove, when he stops the whole thing and talks to the camera. In the Emperor's New Groove game, I remember someone actually complained to me about the fact that he breaks the fourth wall by saying, there's a cook around here. No, he doesn't say that, but he says, like, something like, wow, we're in a video game right now. And, like, the person was, like, actually kind of upset that he... Oh, it's over here. Actually kind of upset that he said this. I'm going to buy a few stuff as well, if you don't mind. I'll take all of them, actually. I'm running low on funds. I have to sell some stuff eventually. Thank you very much. Oh, God, I have a lot of these. Let's just make watermelons. So the context has to be central to your world, and it has to not break your world, I think. Oh, nice. That would have been actually useful before. So, you can have a world that, like, breaks context constantly. Or breaks the worlds outside its context constantly, as long as it continues to do that and it's actually, like, makes sense in the world, I guess. And that's why I feel like Zelda does. Although it has a lot of, like, really cool context to the game. One of the cool things that it does... some sea salt. One of the cool things that it does, actually, is that it like... Oh, I don't know why we're doing this for some cold resistance, I guess. One of the cool things I think it does, personally, is that it sticks to its art style. Nothing looks realistic. None of this looks like the real world outside. And, like, to the point that if they actually showed, like, a real picture in front of, Last of Us style graphics. Let's just put a bunch of meat in this. Let's say they put in, like, Last of Us style graphics into this game. All of a sudden, it would look cool, like, look good in The Last of Us, but in this game, it would look bad because it's completely out of context and actually does not look very good. Meat skewer, that's, at least this gives us health. We should probably use more variations, though. Chillin' trout, some mushrooms, some of that, one of these, another trout. You know what I'm saying? And I think that's, like, I think that's so good, because a lot of people say, like, oh, this game looks stupid and silly because it doesn't look realistic, but that's, like, the world. It sticks to its own guns and it sticks to its own world, which I feel like stuff like Malcolm in the Middle and Lizzie McGuire does on a regular basis. Let's just cook all these spicy peppers. Get some, cold resistance where we're actually heading to the colder areas. But, like, little stuff like walking into that classroom there and seeing that there's, like, this thing on the wall. You know, pick up this, we'll use this, another one of these, another one of these, another one of these, one of these. Seeing that there's on the wall, there's, like, they're teaching young girls. We should probably skip this. Teaching the young girls that, like, these men are bad. They're bad and they only want you for one thing. Like, I'm not saying that's what men want. Like, I'm not saying that at all. But I'm just saying that that's, like, the general thing, I guess. That is the context for their world. Let's see what else we can do here. But of course, then nothing bothers me more when they go out of context, because it's not okay for me anyway, for a book or movie or show to, like, or a game, for the whole entirety of the game to have say in The Last of Us, which, you know, a lot of people consider to be a really good game. If, like, halfway through The Last of Us, like, they started doing this thing where Ellie looks at the camera and goes, "Oh, brother," and smiles, guys, and or say Joel looks at the camera and goes, "They're out there. Ellie goes at it again. She's acting up again." You know, you're like, it would take you out of it instantly. Like, I'm just cooking a bunch of stuff, guys, at this moment. Like, would it take you out of it? Does that type of stuff take you out of it, or would that even matter to you guys? Because personally, like, that would kill me. That would be the end of my feelings towards any game. I would not like that game anymore. It would actually, like, I know it's kind of a petty thing to say. I would not like that game anymore. But it would just not be my favorite thing in the world anymore. I don't know what to say, really. But yeah, I love context in video games. I love, like, games sticking to its context. Like, why is something there? Why do they feel this way? Why are they grown up feeling this way? Like, this is 100 years in the future, and they still feel this way. And obviously because, like, one of the main guys who's a Gerudo, is Ganon, right? Of course you're going to be brought up to feel like he's not the best thing in the world, and men aren't the best thing in the world either. We should go find a bunch of people and talk to them in female armor after this, by the way. So yeah, I took up a lot of time just looking for a cook and talking to that woman, but I feel like this is what Zelda is. It's exactly what Zelda is. But yeah, context. Context, guys. My favorite thing, I think, in video games. And I think Zelda deserves some credit for it, because they keep to their guns, they keep to the context, and they keep to the idea of their own game. Let's go, let's rent one of these things. Hello. Let's seal the deal. Yeah, I wonder if it's just a thing outside Gerudo Town. Oh my god. This is insane. Oh my god. Okay, we're going this way. This is fucking awesome, right? This is awesome! This is so cool, like... I'm about 25 hours into the game, I'd say. What the fuck is that shadow? I'm about 25 hours into the game. Is that a shrine? Can I stop here? Stay there, please. What is this? Okay, let's keep going. Let's go. How far away are we from our destination? Pretty far away. Like other games do it as well. Dark Souls does it as well, where, like, something is there for a reason, always. It's always there for a reason, and it's always, like, someone says something for a reason. No one has wasted breath in Dark Souls. What do you mean I'll take damage? You bastards! How much damage, though? Oh, not a lot. We can survive. We can survive. We'll survive. Oh, you're leading me somewhere? I don't like the looks of this. You know, I'm gonna call you Perry, okay? Yo, Perry, I don't like the looks of this. Let's go in this direction, okay? Okay, so the air is grand now. Okay, that makes sense. We follow the shade. Follow the shade is a good thing. We have to go this way. We have to go into this chasm over here. So this would be impossible for us. This would be incredibly impossible for us to even get to this point without this creature. Because we don't have the sand boots. If we have the sand boots, it would have been easier. But, like, obviously, like, it's going to get very hard in this terrain to actually walk around the place here. And this place in general looks like it's actually tough to get around. Like, I'm not a big fan of all these tribal statues here. I'm actually kind of worried. Oh, wait, stop. Stay there. I think I saw a chest. Oh! You... No! I'm sorry. Go. Right. Go, electric. Damages my health so badly. Man, I don't know when this game... I think we're almost done this game, though, because once this is over, we've one more Divine Beast, and then we're fighting Ganon. That's what's happening. I said I was going to do the main story and, like, a lot of exploration, which I think I did in this game. I think I did a lot of side stuff, I guess. I know, like, it's... Some of the side stuff I did by myself, and I think the reason for that was just because I wanted to play this game by myself when I wasn't playing the game here. Which I think is, like, perfectly reasonable. See, oh my god, Link, you are a convincing woman, Link. Well done. Oh, like this probably. Oh, shit, shit. Oh! Oh, we can do this. We can do this. Go. See how we avoided that? We just stopped. Just let it pass by, Perry. What's Perry? Is Perry the... Perry's the platypus, isn't he? I hope that's not making the mic pop. I hope it's not. Perry the platypus. Petered. On... Peter Platypus. That's not his name. Out of Phineas and Ferb, Dan Povenmire. Is this it? Is this where we stop? Is this where we say goodbye, Perry? Thank you, Perry. You wait there, Perry, okay? Perry was actually a really kind person. I actually think I'm gonna remember Perry for the rest of my life. In fact, I think Perry's gonna remember me. What the fuck are you? Oh, there's statues. Oh, it's one of you! Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, where are you? Where are you? Over here, okay, come here, fight me! Fight me like a goddamn person would! Where are you gone? I can't see you. I can't see you, please, come on, fight. If you're so tough, your order's not tough at all. I have not had trouble with you once. Does that feel good? Huh? Oh, you sliding down? Huh? Huh? What happened? You're embarrassed now, aren't you? It's okay to be embarrassed. People get embarrassed all the fucking time. You like arrows? Where are you? Where are you? I cannot see you. Fight me like a man. Oh, I'll pick up that arrow of yours. Maybe it's mine, actually. Neva's grace is ready. You can fight me all you want now. What felt good? Did that feel good? Duplex bow? Fucking hell. Thank God I got him. Thank God I goddamn murdered him. Man, it felt kind of bad leaving Perry behind. Oh my God, this is... Oh, I get it. This is your order. I need these arrows badly. That's a double hit. Okay, we need to eat something. We can't waste Mipha's grace like this. Probably a waste of food there though, because that we should eat one of the meat skewers. Oh God, we're gonna run out of arrows. We should have bought more. That feel good. Lots of arrows here. That feel good. I'll take that as well. Some more rupees. Oh, we ran out of arrows, I think, did we? Or maybe we could just use a different bow, I guess. We have two more arrows left. Okay, come on. Come on. Felt good. Okay, if you're gonna stay here, okay, like this... Like, is this what they taught you in school when you were, like, learning how to be a warrior? You're like, they're like, okay, just don't actually fight them. Just, like, shoot arrows and disappear. What is it? What is it? What is it now? Oh, so you're not dead, you just disappear, but you still give me stuff? Thanks. Okay. Well, that was easy. It was not easy for me at all. I got fucked up quite a bit. Okay, let's see what we can do in here. Torch. Okay, we can drop the ladle, I guess. Man, I'm gonna do a ladle run at one point. I can't do that, can I? A duplex bow. What? Why am I doing this here? Do they want me to burn all these things? Is it? Oh, yes. Okay. I don't need that though. I could just use the torch, I guess. It's probably an easier thing to use. That's why they gave me the torch. Let's do this. Oh, okay, we can just go up here and do it. There we go. What does this open? Another oh, a chest. Nice. Some sapphires. Arrow always welcome. Let's see. We got a key swing. This is empty. I like this hideout though. So these are like the enemies of these people, right? There we go. I got heat resistance, it's fine. Okay, what's in here? Just a bunch of key swings, okay? We're not doing too bad. Let's burn this one. I think we're looking for a passageway of some sort, maybe, or just looking for a chest, I guess. Oh, nice. I actually need the money because someone informed me that, I kind of knew it in the back of my mind, but at the same time, it was like, yeah, I should have done that instead. I could have just dyed my clothes instead of buying a new set. There we go. And then there's up here, which is what? My torch broke, but I have another torch here, it's fine. But I think I should bring a weapon instead. I really like scimitars. I think like for the entirety of Dark Souls 2 at one point, I actually used like a scimitar for the full game. But that was like way late into my actual playthrough of the game. I'll take some bananas. Mighty bananas. I'll take some of these. Hello, how are you doing? Hey, what are you doing here? This is the hideout of those Yiga thieves who stole the Thunder Helm. If you spot you, they'll call their friends for sure. There's no way you can take them all on. If you only had some way to distract them, but I don't know how. All I ever seen them do is patrol and eat bananas. I haven't seen them do anything else. Okay. I'll play ball with you. Okay, guys, so this should do it for this episode here. I know that I didn't do much in this episode. I just kind of wandered around the place and did nothing. Oh, shit. Bananas. Can I hold these and then drop them here? No! I'm sorry. I effed up already. And this was supposed to do for this episode. Shit. Shit. Oh god. Where are you guys? Come on, fight me like man. Fight me like a man. Mipha's Grace! Mipha's Grace! Mipha's Grace! Oh, Mipha's Grace doesn't work in dungeons? That's really weird. I didn't know that.